so let's get started. Starting with primer, of course, in the usual areas, the T-zone. Next step is, of course, going to be foundation. Here I'm using the NYX Total Drop Control Foundation in the shade Golden Honey. All the shades and the names of the products are in the description section. So quickly blending and buffing this foundation into my skin. I'm speeding through this process because this is what I always do. I'm going to go a little ham on the concealing. I don't usually conceal so much, but I'm going to apply a lot of concealer because I want that bright under eye and white kind of pale look to my face, because we're not going to contour or bronze or highlight or any of that. So just buff your concealer in with the Beauty Blender and make sure it's seamlessly blended in. So this is for the base, like always, just a little more bright. I'm drawing and filling my brows using the Miss Claire Eyebrow Pencil in the shade 02 Dark Brown and making sure they look sharp and nice. And for the eyes, I'm diving into the NYX Ultimate Warm Neutrals palette, taking that mauve shade and putting it all over the lid to create a nice base for all the colors. Taking this red from Miss Claire, I'm going to make this my crease shade and really going to build it up in my crease, going in windswiper motions again and again, because I want it to look like a pop of red smokiness to the eye. So I'm going to dive into the color a couple of times. I wet my brush using Fix Plus and taking that mud brown color from the NYX palette, I'm going to put it on the lid because I'm not going to use any shimmers for this look. So you can use any matte brown shade you have, and then with a clean brush just make sure everything's nice and blended and there's no patchiness to your... Now I'm taking this black eyeshadow from Miss Claire and just going to put it on the outer corners and buff it little bit into my crease. I'm using the edge of my primer bottle so that I don't have any fallout, because with black shadow it's really difficult to control how much you're putting. So you can go messy, but then avoid any fallout by doing this. You get a sharp edge, and then just take a clean brush and blend it all in. And then taking the same shadows I took on my crease, that mud brown from the NYX palette, I'm going to smoke out my lower lash line. And take this red eyeshadow from Miss Claire and put it really in my tear duct, because I want to look like, to have those blood shot red eyes rather than having glitter in my inner corner and on my brow bone. I'm letting it be a little more smoky and bloodshot. Then taking the plum coal, lining my waterline and tight line, and then smudging it on the upper lid. So you can go messy with this, you don't need to be the neatest. I have OCD and I have really controlled hands over all this, but you can smudge it the way you want. Then taking that mud brown shade again, this is going to be interesting. I'm going to smudge it all down my face now using a fluffy blender brush. So just blend it all down your face so that you have that effect of blood dripping or those bruises or that depth to your face, basically, because we've not contoured or added dimension in some other way. So this is how you go ahead to do that. Go randomly just down your face, under your eyes, and just like create that shadow with that one mud brown shade. Now is the fun part, line your lips, fill your lips actually with a red liquid lipstick. I'm using one from Matte Me, I'll name it in the description section. And now with this liquid lipstick, go ahead to line, go outside your lips and create what I'm doing on the screen right now. I can't explain basically. Go randomly, you don't need to be the most precise when it comes to this. Drip it all over your, down your eyes. Be free and let your hands move freely, because we're going to smudge this all out. It might look weird right now, but it's not going to look this neat at the end of the video. So let your hands flow freely. Create the cuts so that it looks like stitches down your face. And then we'll just smudge it all with eyeshadows, mud brown eyeshadows, black eyeshadows. You'll see me do that in the video ahead. So now I'm taking, I think, the black eyeshadow, no, the red eyeshadow, and just on a pencil brush, taking it down my eyes, and the lipstick is still a little wet, so it helps to smudge it well. Just do that everywhere you've applied the red lipstick and you'll create that effect. Now I've taken black eyeshadow on this same pencil brush and I'm smudging the same areas that we did with the red eyeshadow. This will add more shadow to the look. Basically create depth and messiness and the Halloween-y look. I don't need to explain. Extend that stitches line all throughout till your ears. Now what I'm doing is taking a red cream lipstick and putting it over the liquid lipstick because that liquid lipstick is extremely drying. So I want to do something which will need a creamier base. So I'm going ahead with a red liquid creme lipstick and now taking the black eyeshadow on a fluffy brush. I'm going to dab it all over the lips. So this creates that ombre black shadowed lips that make it look a little more zombie-ish, hopefully. I'm not a makeup artist, I just enjoy doing this, so hopefully that's how it turned out to look. Now take the same black eyeshadow and just go all over, messily blending everything in, creating shadows just like you can see. Now I'm taking the Maybelline Drama Gel Liner for the Minnie Mouse button nose. And just go round on the top of your nose and fill it all in with the gel liner. I was doing this for the first time and I'm so nervous. I don't do all this on a daily basis, of course, so just fill it all in. I'm taking the white acrylic paint I have just to create that highlight on my nose because I don't have white liquid liner or anything of that sort. So if you do, you can use that. If you don't, you can always use acrylic paint because you've applied eyeliner on your nose. So I think acrylic paint will do. I'm taking this horror blood thing I got from Madcaps for $65. So I'm really scared to use it. As you can see, I'm comprehending it a lot because I've never used all these things before. But it's damn easy to use. You just gotta drip it down your eyes, down your mouth, wherever you want. It's basically like red water. And it's just going to dry after some time. So it creates that blood look. It will drip all the way down to your face. So just make sure you keep a napkin or something on your clothes and on your lap. So it doesn't drip into that. And create a hot mess. Then just let everything freely drip down your face and dry it all out. So that was all. I just went ahead to add some falsies and grey lenses I've been wearing throughout the tutorial. And that's it. I hope it's spooky enough. I got pretty scared looking at myself when I woke up from filming this. So I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, don't forget to hit the like button. Subscribe to my channel. I make videos every weekend. And the links to all of my social media are down in the description section where I've also shared a lot of Halloween ideas all throughout the week. So happy Halloween!